It's time to chat about the day's more interesting stories with Richard Southern. And Richard, we begin with one of your favorite topics, UFOs.
You know, we've talked about it so much in this segment, Erica. I mean, there's been a lot going on, right? I mean, the U.S. government in like the last year or two has admitted that it's observed objects that it doesn't know what they are. They're moving in ways they don't understand. The U.S. government has basically said UFOs are real. It's not a question of if there are UFOs anymore. It's just a question now of what exactly these things are. The latest to report on this subject is J.J. Abrams, the famous director behind, you know, the new Star Wars movies, the new Star Trek movies. He did the Lost TV show. He's out with this, a new docuseries about UFOs. It's called simply UFO. It premiered this week on Showtime in the States and Crave here in Canada. It depicts the UFO phenomenon as we know. It takes a very serious look at it. Needless to say, I was watching this last night and I saw a very strange alien-like creature in the fourth episode. Take a look at what I saw.
I have a feeling that there's going to be a huge boom in tech in the next 10 years due to the fact that we're understanding a lot more of this reverse engineered tech.
The full U.S. Senate Intelligence Commission report on this phenomenon is due out before the end of the month. Very weird alien-like creature.
There's the superstar himself, Richard Southern, in that documentary. That's amazing.
I'm working with J.J. Abrams now, Erica.
You can add that to your resume. Have that little credit.
I need an IMDb account. I'm working with JJ.
You should, actually. Add that to your IMDb account. Okay, something mysterious has happened on the surface of Mars, speaking of other or outer-worldly phenomenon.
Yeah, we got a theme here today. So, you know, the Mars rover, the new one, the Perseverance, it's up there, and it's drilling holes, and it drilled its first hole, and that's the actual hole it drilled. And the only thing, the only problem was the sample it took disappeared. NASA doesn't know what happened to it. The drill sample was supposed to go into this, a tube. This rover has 43 tubes. When they put the rock in, they seal it up, and these tubes are going to be flowing back to Earth eventually. NASA will send another mission in 10 years to bring them back. But the sample in this case completely disappeared. It wasn't in the tube. It wasn't found lying near the hole. To try and figure out what happened, NASA is instructing the rover to take more close-up pictures of the borehole. They're going to try it again. But that's kind of fascinating, Erica. The first time they tried to drill this hole, it went awry. It's like losing your car keys. You know?
Yeah, I guess so. Or something doesn't want us to see that sample.
Who's getting into the conspiracy? You got to call JJ.
That's on Mars. It's a whole other planet. You never know, right?
Okay. You never know.
Finally, a celebrity chef is behind an outrageous new food combo. We love food here. I'm not sure if I like this combo, though.
Yeah, it's Guy Fieri, but of course, coming out with apple pie hot dog. So it's a hot dog inside an apple pie, Erica.
I got to say nay to that. That does not look like something I want to try.
It's an old beef dog enveloped, he says, in a flaky pie crust topped with apple, mustard drizzle, sugar, and apple pie spice. He's creating this for a baseball game on Thursday called the Field of Dreams game. There he is making it. This is based on the Field of Dreams movie. It's going to be the Yankees and the White Sox playing in the middle of a cornfield in Iowa. So I guess Fieri was trying to make something uniquely American. I mean, hot dogs and apple pie, but
sure.
I don't know about that, Erica.
Would you try it? I don't know. Would you try it?
I'd be worried that my hair would end up looking like Guy Fieri's if I tried that.
I think it's safe to say that won't happen, but I'm not sure if it's going to go down well. I don't know. The combination.
You have one apple hot dog, and next thing you know, you have frosted tips you have to deal with.
All right, Richard. Thanks. We'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.